Good to see you again. We're going to look at another informational text. And this informational text is actually on bling bling, jewelry, diamonds, gold. Yeah, maybe boys think it's not that masculine, but let me tell you, I love jewelry. It's a passion of mine. I don't know if you guys know that. I actually have a book here where I take jewelry and print a picture of a piece of jewelry that I really, really like, and I write about it, write down what kind of stones they are, what kind of materials, and I design and draw it out, or draw another piece based off a piece I like, and then do my own. I was going to show you, here's a few pieces of jewelry that I've designed for me, and also for my wife. If you want to really make your wife happy in the future, get some tips today on bling bling on jewelry. We're gonna read the National Geographic for kids. And this article is by Rose Davidson. It's called Real or Fake? Don't be fooled. Check out these hats to learn if your treasures are for real. Diamonds or duds? People used to believe that diamonds were made by bolts of lightning. That sounds real cool, but it's not true. Diamonds actually develop deep in the ground under great pressure. The gems that are a crystalline form of carbon, a cubic zirconia, sometimes called a CZ, is another form of crystalline material that happens to look like a diamond, but it's worth a lot less. The easiest way to tell a diamond from a CZ imposter is with something called a fog test. Here's how it works. Breathe a puff of air on the diamond in question. If the fog disappears right away, congrats! It's probably a diamond, but if it takes a longer to go away, you might have a cubic zirconian on your hands. Fog doesn't show up on real diamonds because the stone conducts heat so well that the fog evaporates instantly. Never knew that. Proper pearls. This is interesting. People have come up with countless ways to imitate pearls, whether it's with a painted beads or wax glass. So how can you tell a real pearl from an imposter? One way to put a pearl to the test is with your teeth. Gently rub the pearl against your tooth. If it's real, the pearl will feel gritty. Fake ones usually feel super smooth. Using your fingernails works too. If you're only able to produce a bit of powder from the scratching the pearl, it's the real thing. Scratching at a fake pearl long enough will reveal the artificial layer underneath, but don't do this without permission. Please don't go to a jeweler and just start scratching pearls. Serious silver. If you've got a questionable chunk of silver, consider the ice test. Grab a large ice cube from the freezer, put it on top of the metal, and keep your eyes on the ice's reaction. If it starts to melt immediately, the silver's probably real. That's because real silver conducts heat way better than fake, which might melt the ice at a much slower rate. I'm gonna skip cold hard cash because I'm just talking about jewelry and go right on to got gold. Got gold? To find out if your gold will make you rich or deserves a gold medal in trickery, try wearing it for a while. If your skin turns black or green where the metal touched it, then sorry, your gold is phony. Another way to tell if you got fake gold is with a float test. Place your gold object into a glass or bowl of water. Real gold should sink to the bottom of the cup, while fake gold is more likely to float. So now, I've just read this information, digested the text into my mind, just like you would digest a nice hamburger and french fries. And now, the end product of that digestion is not something stinky, but something beautiful that I've written. Something that I put into my own words again, because we talked about earlier this week, plagiarism. We don't want to plagiarize. We don't want to copy what someone else has written. And we also need to make reference to where we got our information. For example, I mentioned earlier that I got it from the National Geographic. The title is Real and Fake by Rose Davidson. So that's what I'm referring to as I put it, the information I got from that article into my own words. So my topic is jewelry. My subtopic I'm going to write about today is real versus fake. So let's go into it. Did you know you can perform an easy test with your breath to see if your diamond is real or fake? If you breathe on it and the fog disappears quickly, it's probably a real diamond. So, I put that in my own words. I actually made it a lot quicker, a lot simpler. You can make it longer. You can put in some personal experiences, whatever. But I just made it a quick couple sentences. Now, I'm gonna write something about pearls. To find out if a pearl is real, you need to rub a pearl with your teeth. And if it feels smooth, remember, if it feels smooth, it's probably fake. Fake gold usually turns your skin black and green, which I never knew. And real gold sinks more quickly in a glass of water. Real silver will melt ice faster than fake silver. And then I referred it, made a reference of where I got the article from, and that information I have interpreted into my own words, and now I put it here, and I'm going to use that for my informational writing. Did I copy? No, I didn't copy. But did I use the information I read and then put it in my words? Yes, and that is A-okay. Smell you later.